Good morning, children. So yesterday we learned about fractions and more its operations and addition, subtraction, everything. Today we are going to see multiplication of fractions. In multiplication of fractions, like I said yesterday, if you are multiplying one fraction with another, you should multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. Let's see an example. If you have 5 by 2 and 3 by 4, then you should multiply 5 with 3 and 2 with 4. This is how we multiply fractions. 5 threes are 15 divided by 2 fours are 8. Okay, so this is how we multiply fractions. Now we are going to see example where we are actually using fractions and fraction multiplication. Okay, so now example, the area, they asked us to find the area of the rectangle. Length of the rectangle is 7 1 by 2 centimeter and breadth is 3 1 by 2 centimeter. Okay, so as you know, this is in mixed fraction and area is multiplication of length into breadth. Now we should convert this into a normal fraction and then multiply it. For multiplication, you don't need it to be a like fraction, so you can multiply like this also. Okay, so 7 2s are 14, 14 plus 1 is 15 by 2, and 3 2s are 6, 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 by 2. So if you are multiplying this 15 by 2 into 7 by 2, in this multiplication you should multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator, right? So 7 5s are 35, 5 8 divided by 15 into 7 will be 85, and then 4 into 4 will be 2 into 2 will be 4. So this is how you multiply fractions. Okay, so now we are going to see of operation of fractions. You might have studied this of operation in 5th standard. For example, 1 by 2 of 4, which means 1 by of 4, that is 1 into 4 divided by 2. First you will write this as 1 by 2 into 4. Okay, so if you have 1 by 2 of 4, then it means 1 by 2 into 4 equal to 4 divided by 2. 1 into 4 will give you 2. This is the of operation. Of operation means it, if in fraction it will be of multiplication. Okay, so let's say where we are using this fraction and how we are using. For example, you have two similar boxes. Okay, now this box, one part is shaded and the other portion is not shaded. Likewise here also, one part is shaded, not shaded, and the other part is shaded. You can write this as 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. If you say you have two dolls, which means 1 plus 1 doll, right? That is how you will write. Then you can write 2 into 1, right? Which is, likewise you can write this as, if you are combining this 2, then you can write 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. You can write this as 2 into 1 by 2. Then you can write 2 by 2, which means dividing this both will give you 1. Likewise, if you combine this two, you can write your one part is shaded and your one part is shaded. So you can shade one part for this one and then the other part for this one. One whole shaded box you'll get, which is equal to 1, and you got the answer. This is the multiplication of fractions. So let's see one more example. So here you have 3 circles, which is divided into 4 parts. So if you see, here you have one part shaded out of 4 portions. Likewise here, 1 out of 4, here 1 out of 4. If you combine these 3, you can write as, see, 1, 2 and 3 shaded parts, portions. Okay, so from here 1 by 4, here 1 by 4 and here 1 by 4, which gives you 3 by 4. Okay, so you can write this in a mathematical expression too. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. These are like fractions. They have same denominator. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 divided by 4, which will give you 3 by 4. 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 by 4. Okay. So this is how you do it in proper fraction. So here 1 is lesser than 4 and you got 3 by 4. And here also 1 by 2, which is lesser than denominator. So look at this example. Here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 portions out of 2 is shaded plus same wise. Here also same. Yeah, same denominator, so you can write 2 plus 2 plus 2 divided by 9, which will give you 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 4 is 4 plus 2 is 6 by 9. Okay, so in mathematical expression you got 6 by 9. We'll see in diagrammatic expansion. So here 2 parts is shaded, here 2 is shaded and here 2 is shaded. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of 9 is shaded. This is how you get multiplication of fractions. Let's see how we are doing here. So this means 3 into 1 by 2 means we have 3 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. This will give you 1 plus 1 plus 1 divided by 2. Which means 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3 into 1 divided by 2. This gives you 3 by 2. Okay. So you can multiply directly as 3 into 1 divided by 2, or you can expand like this and then add and then get the value. They are one and the same. Okay, so let's see another example. We have 3 into 2 by 7. So 2 by 7 plus 2 by 7 plus 2 by 7. This will give you 2 plus 2 plus 2 divided by 7. 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6 by 7. Or 3 into 2 divided by 7. 3 into 2 is 6 divided by 7. Here, so we have all seen all this proper fraction. 2 by 7 is proper fraction, and here 1 by 2 is proper fraction. Now we are going to see with the improper fraction. Improper fraction also, it's one and the same. We are going to multiply this with the numerator and write the answer. So we have 2 5 by 3s. 5 by 3 plus 5 by 3. This is like fraction, so 5 plus 5 divided by 3. 5 plus 5 is 10 divided by 3, or 2 into 5 by 3. 2 5s are 10 by 3. Likewise here, 8 by 7 plus 8 by 7 plus 8 by 7 equal to 8 plus 8 plus 8 divided by 7. 8 plus 8 is 16. 16 plus 4, 8 is 24 divided by 7. Or 3 8s are 24 by 7. We have exercise. They have given you, try this sums as, find 2 by 7 into 3. So 2 by 7 into 3. This is also nothing but 2 by 7 plus 2 by 7 plus 2 by 7, or 2 into 3 divided by 7. They are one and the same. If multiplication is there, if it is either front or back, it's one and the same. You have to multiply it with the numerator. Okay. So try those sums they have given and find the answers. Okay. Okay. So now see this example. Okay. In this one part is shaded 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2 and here 1 by 2. If you are combining these three, then you can write 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which is 1 plus 1 plus 1 divided by 2, which will give you 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 by 2. Likewise, if you are adding them in a pictorial way, see, here you have 1, here you have 1, and here you have 1. But we have only 2 portions, which means we have 3 shaded parts, 3 shaded portions. Two fully shaded portions and 1 off shaded portions. Here we'll be having a portion which is not shaded, but here 3 portions are shaded and off. Okay. So this is how we are representing the fractions in a picture. Okay. So they have given us a question to solve. We'll try and solve that. Example 5. In a class of 40 students, there are 40 students in a class. 1 by 5 of total students like to study English. 1 by 5 of 40 students likes to study English. And then 2 by 5 of students like to study maths. They have asked us 3 questions. First is, how many students like to study English? So 1 by 5 portion of 40 students like to study English, which means 1 by 5 into 40 likes to study English. This will give you the number of students who are like to study English. Okay, now 1 into 40. 1 into 40 divided by 5. This is equal to 40 by 5. Here you are 5, here you are 40. You can divide both up and down by 5, right? So if you divide 40 by 5, you will get 8. And down 1, which is 8. So 8 students likes to study English. The second question they asked, how many students like to study maths? Now 2 by 5 of 40 students like to study maths, right? So 2 by 5 into 40 likes to study maths, which means 2 into 40 divided by 5. 2 into 40 is 80 divided by 5. Now we can divide both up and down by 5. If you divide that up by 5, you'll get 16. If you divide 5 by 5, you'll get 1, which is 16 students likes to study maths. And now, what fraction of the total number of students like to study science? So in this, you have totally 40 students. 8 of them likes English and 16 of them likes maths. If you minus these two from total number of students, you will get the remaining students who likes science, right? So number of students likes science will be total number of students minus number of students who likes maths and science, maths and English, which is 8 plus 16, or you can see total number of students, number of students liking maths and English will be 8 plus 16. Number of students liking maths and English will be 8 plus 16. 8 plus 16 will be 24. If you minus this 24 from total number of students, you will get number of students who like science. So 40 minus 24 is 16. So 16 students like science. Okay, this is how you should solve the problems. So now we are going to see, this is kind of a match. We are going to match the first one, this with pictorial representation of them. Okay, so now 2 into 1 by 5, which means there are two pictures, okay, that has 1 by 5, one portion of 5 is shaded. So now let's see how many 2s are here. Here you have 3 pictures, and here you have 2, and here you have 3, and here you have 2. So this and this have 2 pictures. Now they have shaded one shaded parts out of 5. Here you have only 2 out of 1 is shaded, but here you have only 2 portions. But see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here you have 5 portions out of which 1 is shaded. So D is the first one. Okay, so second one, here you have two pictures, out of that one portion is shaded out of 2. First you'll see how many balls are there. Here you have 3 pictures, and here you have 2, and here you have 3. So this must be the answer. And here see, 1 out of 2 is shaded in both. So this is the answer for B. Now you can see 3 pictures are here and 3 pictures are here remaining. out of 3 is shaded. Let's see here. 1, 2 and 3. In 3 out 2 is shaded, which means this is A. And the remaining one, 3 is there, and 1 out of 4. 1 out of 4 is shaded. So this will be the C. Okay. So do the homework which I have given you and try to solve more problems on this one. Okay. Bye, children. Tomorrow we'll see you.